It's Saturday, September 27th. Let's play the Booster Box game. Box number one. Can we get $100? How does this game work? I'm about to break open a booster box within 24 hours of launch and see if I can immediately sell enough cards to get $100, which is what I paid for the box. If I can sell enough cards to get $100, then I will do so immediately. Then take that $100 and buy a second booster box. I will keep doing this until I bust a box where I can't get to $100. Will I break open 10 boxes or only one? Let's find out. I'm going to go fast here. I'm only showing the foils, rares, and mythics, and I'm only showing prices on rares and mythics. Keep in mind that $1 to $2 cards are not something I can sell. It costs me about $2.50 per item to cover the cost of shipping, envelopes, top loaders, as well as eBay's seller fees. For the purposes of this game, I will not be using TCG player average prices like normal, but instead I'll be using eBay prices at the lowest available buy it now price. That's how I'll be selling the cards so quickly. I need to list them at the lowest possible price. So remember, these prices are right after launch, and the prices I saw on eBay literally minutes after filming the video. Thank you. Wow, yes. So this was a very good booster box. By selling only 5 cards, I recoup what I paid for the box, including the additional $12.50 needed for shipping and handling and seller fee costs. I listed these cards on Saturday at the prices shown here, which at the time were the lowest on eBay. They were all sold by Monday morning. I have essentially just gotten the remaining rares from booster box number 1, as well as all the commons and uncommons for free. I can quit now. But that wouldn't be much fun. This is the booster box game, remember? Let's keep going until I hit a total washout. Remember, I waste my money so that you don't have to. So I shipped out the cards and drove from the post office down to my local game store, where I used the funds from selling those 5 cards to buy booster box number 2. Let's see what I got. Keep in mind that it is now Monday. Prices have changed in the few days since the launch. Interestingly, some cards such as Mantis Rider have gone up quite a bit in value. The prices I am listing here are what I am seeing as the lowest cost for these cards as of Monday afternoon. Uh-oh, do you see the problem here? Since I have to sell so many individual cards in order to reach the $100, my shipping and handling costs are much larger than with box number one. I gave a bit of thought as to whether this means I can't make it to box number two, but then I thought of this. If I listed all four of the fetch lands as one multi-card sale on eBay, I would only need $250 to cover the shipping and handling. Even with these cards bundled together, I was still a little short, so I also took the two Zergo Helm Smashers and sold them together as well. The Zergos were the last item to sell. I almost thought they wouldn't, but someone did buy them by Wednesday morning. So I just barely made the $100 requirement for another box. And I had to sell off everything of value from that second box in order to do so. Alright, it's now Wednesday morning. So far, I've really only spent the initial $100 on the first box, but I've also sold off most of the cards of interest and value. Let's see what we got. What an epic epic fail of a box. Even if I somehow sold everything, including the $1 bulk cards, and somehow didn't have shipping and seller fees, I still wouldn't have $100. Look at how many $1 bulk rares a box contains compared to anything worth over even $3. Sure, a few individual packs have some financial value, but it's a gamble, and like most gambling, in the long run, the house always wins. I hope you had fun watching me play the booster box game. Remember, whether buying boxes or singles, be sure to spend that money at your local game store whenever possible. You can't play Magic at Target and Walmart.